हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 5 और चैप्टर नंबर 8 अल्टरनेटिव फ्यूल एंड एग्जॉस्ट इमिशंस। सो इन दैट प्रीवियस 4 लेक्चर्स वी हैड डिस्कस द डिफरेंट अल्टरनेटिव फ्यूल्स, देयर सुटेबिलिटी फॉर एसआई इंजिन एंड सीआई इंजिन, एज वेल एज वी डिस्कस द इमिशन फ्रॉम एसआई इंजिन एंड सीआई इंजिन, एज वेल एज वी डिस्कस द कंट्रोलिंग सिस्टम, इमिशन कंट्रोलिंग सिस्टम, नेमली the thermal reactor, PCB system, ELCD and EGR system were discussed in that previous lecture. So now the last part of this chapter we are going to be discuss, that is a catalytic converter emission norms, the standard emission norms and the catalytic converters. Today in this we are going to be discuss. So let's discuss the catalytic converter. So catalytic converters are now almost universally used for exhaust emission control in spark ignition engine vehicles. The catalytic converter consists of a bed of an active catalytic material housed in metal casing. Meaning, so in 70s automotive manufacturers begin installing catalytic converter to assist in meeting tougher emission standards, so that it will going to reduce the emissions or these pollutants from the vehicles. So from 70s such a catalytic converters are to be installed with the vehicles. So the catalytic converter is nothing but a bed of active material housed in a metal casing. Getting it is housed in a metal casing. Now the exhaust gases flow is directed over this catalyst. Getting so the exhaust gas flow is directed over the catalyst bed where the pollutants are converted to harmless gases. Getting where these harmful gases are to be converted into harmless gases. So the catalytic converter has advantage over the thermal reactor as high conversion rates of pollutants are obtained at moderately low inlet exhaust gas temperature, and the engine parameters like compression ratio, spark timing, air fuel ratio, etc. can be maintained at the level required for optimum engine combustion and performance. Hearing? So in that way the catalytic converters is popular one in the vehicles. So a catalytic converter besides its housing has a three main components. First catalyst, second substrate or support, and third intermediate coat or wash coat. So a catalytic is a material that can speed up chemical action without changing itself. So catalyst is nothing but a material is going to boost the chemical action, and there is no any change is observed in the material getting of this catalyst. Getting, so several type of this catalytic materials are to be used which will promote the desired reactions. Getting several types of these catalytic materials to promote the desired reactions to convert pollutants at low temperature have been investigated. So these include oxides of base metal, example copper, chromium, nickel, cobalt, and the noble metals namely platinum, palladium and rhodium. So base metal oxides, although found to be effective at higher temperature, but they sinter and deactivate when they subjected to high end exhaust gas temperature of conventional engine operation. So their conversion efficiency is severely inhibited getting by the sulfur dioxide. So the base metal catalysts are required in a relatively large volume, and consequently due to high thermal inertia they took longer heat up to operating temperature. Therefore in practice only the noble metals are used as they have high specific activity, high resistance to thermal degradation, superior cold start performance, low deactivation caused by fuel sulfur. Hearing, so by that way these noble metals are having the advantages over the base metal. Getting, so by that way these metals, noble metals, are to be used as a catalyst in the catalytic converter. So automotive catalytic converter are, that is, platinum, palladium, rhodium, or a combination of these metals. So platinum and palladium are used to change HC and CO into CO2. Getting? So this platinum and palladium are used to change HC and CO into CO2 and water vapors. Rhodium acts to reduce the oxides of nitrogen emissions. Meaning, so due to enhanced emission standard, later model catalytic converters now use cerium to attract and release oxygen inside the converter to help in the process of changing HC and CO to CO2 and H2O. This is water vapors. So such that research and development is still going on. Newly these materials are to be used. Newly these modifications are to be
so the catalyst used.
That is the agent the inside the catalytic converter is either ceramic beds or honeycomb shaped blocks. So all catalytic converters are encased in stainless steel housing. That metal this casing body is provided. So stainless steel is used on newer vehicle with catalytic converters because the production of water will rust traditional exhaust system metals in only few years. As the HC and CO emissions are to be converted, the harmful gases are to be converted into harmless, means into the CO2 and water vapors. So these water vapors may be rust the traditional exhaust system metals. Getting? And to avoid this rusting, stainless steel is purposefully used in catalytic converters as a housing. Getting? So the casing is of stainless steel is to be provided. So though these noble metals although are more expensive, getting, see this platinum, palladium, rhodium, they are more expensive, but the amount required for an automotive catalytic converter is small. It is about 1 to 2 gram only. Getting, amount is 1 to 2 gram only. So the noble metal loading typically varies from 1 to 1.8 gram per liter of catalytic converter volume. Getting? So the mixture of this platinum palladium in 2:1 ratio is usually employed as oxidation catalyst. Getting? As oxidation catalyst, palladium has higher specific activity than platinum for oxidation of CO, for oxidation of CO, for oxidation of olefins, for oxidation of methane, and oxidation of aromatics. For that, the platinum and palladium are having the similar activity. Rhodium is primarily a NO reduction catalyst. Getting? It is a primarily NO reduction catalyst. So the NO reduction activity of noble metals is in order of, it is more in rhodium than the palladium and than the platinum. Getting? So in this way, such these noble metals are to be used, or they have to be combined in the catalytic converter. So here it is shown, here engine is there, exhaust, what are the exhaust gases are there, the HCCO passing through this catalytic converter. So these harmful gases are converted into the harmless gases, namely CO2 and water vapors. So these water vapors may be going to rust the traditional exhaust system metal. And because of that, here this traditional exhaust system metal is now replaced by the stainless steel casing. Getting? To avoid the rusting of this. So stainless steel catalytic converter housing are designed to resist the heat. Before the catalytic converter can operate, an operating temperature of around 300 degrees Fahrenheit must be reached. Then only this plays their role. So this can be honeycomb block type catalytic converter. Exhaust gases flow through this honeycomb block. One section of this catalytic converter is honeycomb shape. So there are different types of catalytic converters: monolithic converter, two-way converter, three-way converter, dual bed converter. Like there are different that catalytic converters are to be used. So monolithic converter uses ceramic honeycomb catalytic. Small ceramic beds converter are referred to as pellet type catalytic converter. Two-way catalytic converters only convert HC and CO. With two-way converter, NOx is not converted. Two-way converter are coated with platinum only. Two-way converter are sometimes referred as oxidation converters, as it only converts the HCNCO into CO2. Three way electric converters are convert all three exhaust gases HCCO and three way catalytic converters usually plated with rhodium and platinum. Three way converters are also called as reduction converters. So here dual bed catalytic converters is an oxidation and reduction converter built into one unit. So HCCONMX is passing through this honeycomb shape, these ceramic beds. Here mixing chamber is there. Again here ceramic beds are provided. At the end we get the CO2 and H2. So dual bed catalytic converter must be at an operating temperature of 130 degrees Fahrenheit. When the engine is cold, additional air is forced into the exhaust manifold to aid in the burning and reduction of HCl CO. So in that way it is also having the good for the cold weather conditions. So on warm engine air is forced into converter to aid in burning exhaust gases. As exhaust gases flow into the in front part of the converter, HCCO and NOx is reduced. So as exhaust flow into mixing chamber, additional air is added to continue the burning process. Exhaust gases is passed into the rear part of the converter to reduce the HCCO2 and NOx. So in that way the catalytic converter is very useful to avoid to reduce the emission pollutants into the atmosphere. They are going to arrest, it is going to convert the harmful gases into the harmless gases. Now we will discuss the emission norms Bharat Stage. So Automotive Research Association of India, that is known as ARAI, are decided to implement Bharat Stage norms. These norms are for regulating the vehicular emission in India only. Expressed in terms of weight of pollutants emitted per kilometer of vehicle run. The gasoline vehicles were being tested on idle carbon monoxide emission, diesel vehicles for free exhalation smoke. So Bharat Stage emission norms for cities Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, Pune, Surat, Kanpur, Agra. These are the big metropolitan cities in our India. So the proposed norms are getting harmonized. So proposed norms to be harmonized. Bharat Stage 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 they are going to skip. Now we are going to be used the Bharat Stage 6. So currently India is still lagging the behind the Europeans as well as United States of that India, sorry, United States of that America, we are going to be lagging, getting our norms are still lagging, but we are trying to harmonize with these norms. So Indian government is keen to have norms at par with US and Europe. Emission norms are getting day by day, it is a stricter, getting as we know that currently the Bharat Stage 4 vehicles are now to be in. 31st March 2020 is the last date for Bharat Stage. All the two wheelers, four wheelers, all types of vehicles. And from 1st of April 2020, we are going to use Bharat Stage 6 vehicles. So objective of engine developer is to have clean and efficient combustion. That is the main. So if you see in this layout, so BS1 nationwide is started at 2000. Then during 2005 we are at the BS2, Bharat Stage 2. During 2010 we are BS3. During 2015 we are at BS4. And now during 2020 currently we are nationwide going to be implement the BS6. This is a proposed timeline in India's auto fuel version and policy 2025 published in 2014. So our aim is Bharat Stage next, that is 2014. So this Bharat Stage 5 here we skip and directly Bharat Stage 6 is implemented during the 2020. So Bharat Stage 5 we are going to be skip and Bharat Stage 6 government implemented in 2020. Similarly, China is having China 1, nationwide China 2. They are ahead of us. In 2007 only they are implemented China 3. 11 only they are 4. 14 only they are 5. 18 only again they are going to be 6. Hearing. Likewise, the China is also our, that is most forward in the norms in against our India. So here it will shows the road to reform. So if you see here, so this is for CI engine, diesel engine, BS4 norms 2010, CO emission gram per kilometer 0.5, that is acceptable range. HC plus NOx 0.3 gram per kilometer is acceptable. NOx 0.25 is acceptable. Particulate matter 0.025 acceptable. Now as per Bharat 6 in 2020, CO 0.5, then HC NOx emission, that is again decreased to 0.17 from 0.3 to 0.17. Here NOx emission 0.25 to 0.08. Particulate matter again it is reduced 0.0045. This is a performance number. So again Euro 6 they are implemented 2014, where now our Bharat 6 is now equivalence with the Euro 6. If you see here, our Bharat 6 is equivalence with the Euro 6. So again that is for gasoline engine, petrol engine, that is a for CO it is a 1 gram per kilometer, HC 0.1 gram kilometer, NOx 0.08 gram per kilometer. Now 6 CO as it is, HC as it is, only NOx is 0.06 gram per kilometer. Now Euro 6 in 2014 only they are implemented these norms, and now that's why India is lagging far behind the European countries. So now see the Bharat stage comparison between Bharat stage 4 and 6. CO emission here 0.5 to 0.74 gram per kilometer. 0.5 to 0.74, same. HC that is a reduce, decrease. NOx that is a large change. PM particulate matter again it is a changed. So in this way emission norms are to be becomes the strict. So in this also you can see the pollution check. So particulate matter 2.5 emitted by various vehicles in kg per day. So it shows 2 wheelers, 3 wheelers, 4 wheelers, light commercial vehicle, buses, trucks. Meaning so 2 wheelers particulate matter that is 33%. Likewise they are mentioning the percentage here. Then oxides of nitrogen emitted by various vehicles, NOx emissions, so that is more by the again the buses and trucks and the light commercial vehicles. Getting light commercial vehicles. So effect of successive Bharat stage standards BS1, so reduction of 58% from BS1 to BS2, 0.36. Here it is a 0.36. Now 0.15. Hearing 0.15. BS3 0.1. Then 0.02. 0.01. Hearing. So likewise reduction is going to be by percentage. It is throughout these years for particulate matter. For NOx oxides of nitrogen, BS1 8 gram per kilometer, for BS2 it becomes 7, for BS3 5, BS4 3.5, now for BS6 it is a 0.4 gram per kilometer. Getting so now as it is expected that BS6 is launched on 1st of April 2020. Now it is implemented, it is now launched. So Euro norms are again European emission standard define the acceptable limits for exhaust emission of new vehicle sold in European Union's and this EEA member states. So the emission standard are defined in series of European Union directives staging the progressive introduction of increasingly triggered standards. So expressed in terms of weight of pollutants emitted again per kilometer of vehicle run. The European standards are followed by most of the countries including India. So the proposed norms are getting harmonized. We are going to try to harmonize with the European norms. Currently India is lagging behind the Europeans and these United States. Indian government is keen to have norms at par with US and Europe. Emission norms are getting stricter. Objective of Indian developers is to have clean and efficient combustion. So here one slide is there that shows that how that European norms are to be implemented. So Euro 1 is at July 1992. First registration 1993, Euro 2 1996, registration of first vehicle 1997, Euro 3 2000, registration of vehicle 2001, likewise Euro 4, Euro 5A, 5B 2009, 2011, 6B, 6B, 6C, 6D, again 6D, so 6D again in January 2020 and the vehicle is to be registered, first registration will be in January 2021. So you see here the CO emission is a 0.50, NOx 0.80, HC plus NOx 0.170 and particulate matter 0.0045. So in that way Europeans that norms are stricter and our India is going to try to harmonize our Bharat state norms with this Euro norms. So in the examination point of view, they are going to ask the short note on the Bharat norms and Euro norms. So it is nothing but the norms which are indicating that how much that percentage or how much that amount of these exhaust pollutants in the exhaust, that is gram per kilometer. Likewise, these norms are going to become the stricter day by day.